The Philadelphia Flyers are the focus of today's 30 and 30 series. Matt Wehmeyer alongside Dan Rosen. And Dan, if the NHL gave out a Jekyll and Hyde award last season, the Flyers would have won it, I do believe. They ended the regular season red hot to get into the playoffs, but their offseason, a bit underwhelming.
Yeah, I agree on underwhelming, definitely. I mean, they brought in Dale Weiss and Boyd Gordon as NHL free agents. Not home run signings there. Weiss can be a third line guy. He can bump into the top six if need be, but more of a third line guy. And Boyd Gordon's a fourth line guy. He'll win some faceoffs, play on the penalty kill. Neither one of these guys are home run signings. Cap constraints really hurt the Flyers in this offseason. And they're also hoping some of their own develop. Guys like Travis Sanheim and Samuel Morin and Ivan Provorov and Travis Konechny. These are prospects that the Flyers are hoping to get some impact from. Not all of them, but at least some of them. One of them would be nice this season, and that would go a long way for this team.
They have a top line as good as you'll find as any team in the NHL. Braden Schenn, Claude Giroux, and Wayne Simmonds. Beyond those three, though, they could use some bounce-back seasons from some key guys.
Yeah, Jacob Voracek headlines this list. He had only 55 points last season after having 81 the season before that. I'm not suggesting that Voracek needs to be a point-per-game player, but he needs to get back up into that 65-70 point area. And the other guy I'm looking at is Sean Couturier, who needs to start providing this team more offense. He did start providing more offense last season with 39 points in 63 games. That's an average of 0.619 points per game, and that's the best of his career. His previous career high was 0.475 points per game in a season. So he's finally starting to show signs that he's more than just a shutdown centerman. And I think 50 points this season should be a goal for Sean Couturier.
It seems like we have this discussion almost every season when it comes to the Flyers, but can either Steve Mason or Michael Neuwirth grab the reins as that number one goaltender?
Well, that's a great question. Goaltending remains obviously the biggest question around the Flyers, but let's look at something that might surprise some people. The Flyers were eighth in the NHL last season in save percentage at .920. That's part of the reason why they made the playoffs. It's part of the reason why they went 16-6-3 down the stretch to get into the playoffs. If the tandem of Mason and Neuwirth can do that again, they'll be in contention. For me, the bigger question is on the prospect development. Are guys like Provorov and Sanheim and Morin, Konechny, are any of them ready to be impactful players this season? Remember the impact that Shane Gostisbehere made last season when he was brought up from the AHL. He changed the dynamic of the Philadelphia Flyers. Provorov might be that guy this season. They're hoping at least one, maybe two of those guys that I mentioned, of the four I mentioned, can be that guy. And if it is, it will go a long way. They need to continue to infuse some youth and these prospects into this team.
Now, as we touched on, the Flyers had to get red hot down the stretch those final 25 games to steal a playoff spot. Are they going to find themselves back there in 2017?
Well, I think they're a bubble team again, and I think a lot depends on the prospect development and on the offense, improved offense from Voracek and Couturier. They got hot, like you said, at the end of last year to get in. It's hard to find that hot streak again. I have them missing by just a hair. They'll be close. They're going in the right direction, but I think even missing this season will be okay if they can get a prospect develop going on just like they had with Gostisbehere. I have them missing, though.